Hello and welcome back to No Bullshit. Today we turn to talking about one of the biggest shows on television right now, HBO's Game of Thrones. This series is about halfway through its highly anticipated final season right now. And needless to say, the hype is getting real, real quick. Not only is Game of Thrones the talk of the town everywhere right now, but also, the actors from the show are getting lots of deserved attention on social media. There have been posts, pictures, fan speculations, and more floating around all over the place. But apparently, not all of this attention is being welcomed by all of the show's actors. In fact, one of the more obscure actors from the show recently clapped back at a meme made with quotes from his character. Miltos Yerul Mo, an English actor, best known for his role as Serial Pharrell in the first season of Game of Thrones, well, this short-lived but significant character was the guy who first taught Arya Stark how to sword fight. Serial is also well known for his famous quote that says, "What do we say to the God of Death?" To which Arya would reply, "Not today." And well, it's this quote that has been repurposed by a conservative-leaning website that got the actor who played Serio a little triggered, even going so far as to express disapproval of the new meme made from his most famous on-screen quote. As you might have guessed already, this actor is a stark liberal, clearly, and he's also a borderline socialist who didn't take too kindly to conservatives taking his character, end quote, into an anti-socialist direction. For more details on this story, let's turn to an article from Newsweek called "Game of Thrones Serial Pharrell Actor Says Not Today to Capitalism." Check this bullshit out. English actor Miltos Yerul Mo, best known as Arya's dance instructor, Serial Pharrell, in the first season of Game of Thrones, doesn't appreciate his character's catchphrases being deployed against socialism. Yerul Mo objected to a meme tweeted by The Daily Wire, a right-wing news site founded by former Breitbart editor and conservative pundit Ben Shapiro, which rewrites Pharrell's last question to Arya, "What do we say to the God of Death?" In the Daily Wire version, Pharrell instead asks, "What do we say to socialism?" And then below, we can see the original meme that sparked this controversy. It really shouldn't be that controversial, though. Anyone defending socialism needs to get their head checked. Clearly, if this guy thinks that's a winning public strategy, he doesn't know what he's talking about at all. Think about it. This is an actor who was made famous because of a capitalist entertainment industry here in America. And they also used technology to produce this show that came out of innovations coming from capitalism and its competitive system. Shit, Comrade Serio is even using the Twitter platform, which was also made popular by capitalism, and he's using it to rebuke capitalism in the same breath. Really can't make this kind of hypocritical bullshit up. "I do not condone this," Yerul Mo replied, sharing his displeasure in a tweet that quickly garnered 135,000 likes, more than 10 times that of the Daily Wire original. Because more likes means they were more right or something, I guess. Please. He got more likes because he's an actor on a heavily biased, liberal-run social media network. Twitter even made this controversy into one of their little dumb moments, which further spread Comrade Serio's anti-capitalist propaganda. Yerul Mo agreed with another user's more pointed critical characterization of the Daily Wire tweet. They see things the left like and then try to ruin it for them by trying to get it associated with fascism or white supremacy. Animator at My2K wrote, "Hashtag truth." Yerul Mo responded, "Wow. Just wow. I can't believe that actor actually agreed with this libtard nutbar." For the record, Game of Thrones isn't a thing that just the left-wingers like. Everyone likes Game of Thrones, regardless of political affiliations. And what's this nonsense about getting it associated with fascism or white supremacy? Where the hell is that even coming from? There is nothing even remotely related to fascism or white supremacy in this meme that the Daily Wire tweeted. These are just meaningless liberal buzzwords that they throw around willy-nilly, without caring or knowing what they actually mean. I mean, take the term fascism here, for example. While liberals like this like to pretend fascism is equivalent to being right-wing or conservative, it's really not. Fascism means a government that's authoritarian, oppressive, and all-encompassing, usually led by a dictator. Does that sound familiar to anyone? Well, that's because the most prominent socialist or communist regimes in world history are all run this way. Stalin and Gorbachev were in Russia, Mao in China, or even Fidel Castro on the much closer island of Cuba. Yes, time and time again, the socialists and communists are the ones who actually become fascists, oppressive dictators, and meanwhile, the United States were the ones holding free and fair elections this entire time. But somehow, an American-based conservative-leaning website like the Daily Wire, they're fascists and white supremacists now. What a goddamn joke. It's also worth mentioning that the Daily Wire is run by Ben Shapiro, a prominent and proud Jewish American, so I don't think he's going to be pulling for white supremacists with that kind of background. But hey, that's just me being rational and reasonable, and not jumping to these bullshit liberal bias conclusions. In subsequent frequent exchanges with socialists and other leftists, Yarlomo described himself as a comrade, tweeting raised fist in solidarity with socialism. Either fight for the people or for your own interests, Yarlomo wrote. Either you believe in democracy and grassroots-based equality or you're a fascist. It really is that simple. I will always stand for people over self-interest. Well done, Sirio. I guess calling you comrade really was wholly and completely accurate here. That's not something you should really be proud of, though, buddy. Socialism is a failed system that has never worked. At the very least, it's never produced the success and prosperity that capitalism has. Not even close. Venezuela, Cuba, Bolivia, Brazil, you name it, and socialism has tried to ruin it. Or what about this actor's Greek background? I wonder how Greece's socialist-leaning economy has been doing lately. Oh yeah, that economy crashed and burned just a few years ago, and the whole nation almost collapsed because of it, kind of like what's happening in Venezuela now. But for some reason, this miltose actor guy, he wants us to follow their failed socialist lead? No thank you. And I'm also not going to buy this virtue signaling, you're a man of the people bullshit tied with it either. You're not saving any lives by pushing socialism, dude. In fact, you might even be endangering them, because if socialism did come to be here or anywhere else, you better believe the people of that area are going to suffer for it eventually. Food shortages, bread lines, devaluing of the currency, and eventually, a complete breakdown of the whole government system. That's what's going to happen if someone adopts socialism. But hey, who are we kidding here anyway? This miltose actor guy doesn't even have any kind of real influence. The only reason he's even getting this attention now is because Game of Thrones is so hype right now. And he happened to play a beloved character on that show many years ago. But soon, Game of Thrones will be over in a couple more weeks. And shortly after that, the world will totally forget who the hell this miltose guy even is. Next, before we go today, let's look at one more article about this story. The AV Club had a pretty liberal hot take on all of this too, which I think we could all get a good laugh at as well. It's called, Sirio Pharrell has no time for your crappy pro-capitalist memes, thanks. Check this one out. Suggesting that his personal philosophies fall more in line with Valor Morghulis than Valor Doreus, because honestly, what's the fun of a system in which all men must serve if it's at the behest of a dwindling number of all-consuming mega-corporations? Actor miltose Sirio Pharrell, Yarlomo, expressed his annoyance this week at having his character co-opted for some shitty pro-capitalist memes. Specifically, Yarlomo was annoyed at Ben Shapiro's well-lubricated crap factory, The Daily Wire, which apparently looked around, saw that this Game of Thrones thing was hot right now, and spent 40 seconds knocking out the following attempt at alleged humor. Well, I thought it was pretty funny. And what childish, biased, and uneducated writing coming from the AV Club here? They couldn't even spell Game of Thrones right at the end there. Let alone could they deliver a legitimate and poignant account of this meme story. And not to defend the Daily Wire too much, but they're not some kind of crap factory as suggested. They report news, break stories, and share opinions, often. And they're certainly better put together than this leftist rag that's hating on them now. And also, it's been well known that Ben Shapiro and others at the Daily Wire, they've been big fans of Game of Thrones since the beginning. So let's not pretend they just started memeing the show now because it's gotten so popular. And that kind of tactic isn't even a conservative thing to begin with. Really, it's the leftists who see popular things and try and invade those spaces and take over. We've seen this time and time again on this show over the years, with industries like video games, comic books, and popular movie series like Star Wars and Marvel Cinematic Universe. They've all had SJWs try and take them over. So, if anything, these anti-capitalist liberals are projecting again, because they're the ones who are actually trying to take over wildly popular things just cuz. Next, what do these people all have against capitalism anyway? This is a highly successful system that has made many of us employed, well-paid, and happy and healthy too. Again, it's the same capitalist system that brought Game of Thrones to the spot of top TV show in the world, which also made this miltose actor guy famous and recognized worldwide. But for some reason, he and the AV Club here, who all benefit from free market capitalism, well, they ironically oppose it publicly too. Why? Well, they probably don't even know fully why, but I assume it's partly because they want to virtue signal to their radical leftist friends. And also, socialism is coming in vogue again, because the American Democrats are going further and further to the far left extreme. But while Yarlomo is pretty clear about his status as a comrade, what of Pharrell? After all, he hails from Braavos, seat of the Iron Bank, which is the most clearly capitalist institution serving the people of Westeros and beyond. But then, Sirio is the former first sot of Braavos, after all, so it's possibly got sick of doing the water dance on behalf of a bunch of capitalist pig dogs. There's also the occasional discussed fan theory that Arya's dance instructor is a faceless man who continually pops up throughout her life. And while Anonymous Death Cult certainly has some of the trappings of capitalist philosophy, their track record on killing rich merchants probably speaks otherwise. Sirio's charge, meanwhile, is pretty clear in her stance on these sorts of issues. After all, she's the one who took down Littlefinger, long the frontrunner over a private poll of Game of Thrones characters most likely to moonlight as predatory venture capitalist douchebags. Jesus Christ, AV Club. You're really doubling down on this anti-capitalist stuff, huh? Damn. But I still really don't get where all this hate comes from. Neither this article nor the actor and his tweets have really ever explained why they hate capitalism at all. They just call us pigs and douchebags and move on with their day. Like we're supposed to assume making money in capitalism makes you evil or something. Please. I've already gone over how specifically the socialists are the real villains and how their system doesn't work either. And meanwhile, I've also explained why capitalism does work. Work, industry, and business, they need this kind of competition. And they need the profit motivation that capitalism provides. Working in a socialist system is much less appealing because you have no motivation to make more money and to work harder, since everything is redistributed and given away for free anyway. And sure, free stuff sounds nice and it is easier, but I would much rather work a real job and get paid well and buy my own nicer stuff. Over working some shitty job and getting shitty stuff for free, government handouts are never that cool. But hey, that's just me, and I'm just a simple man with simple pleasures. In the end, there's nothing wrong with making money in capitalism. Sure, the system isn't perfect, but no system is. And capitalism is certainly the best system we've got in the modern world right now. Really, I think liberal assholes like this Game of Thrones actor and the libtard writers backing him up here, well, they're just lazy bastards who hate rich people just cuz. Because they make money and live better lives than they do. But they usually earn that lifestyle too. Sure, wealth can be passed down to their generations of kids and grandkids, but at some point, someone is working and being successful and earning all that money. Socialists don't believe in that though. They hate rich people, so they claim they are evil and didn't earn it, when really, that's not true at all. What do you guys think? Why does this Game of Thrones actor hate capitalism so much, despite it making him rich and famous? And why do you think these anti-capitalist socialists hate rich people so much? Do they hate us because they ain't us? Comment your thoughts on everything below, and thanks for watching No Bullshit. Hit that like button if you enjoyed this video, and we'll see y'all next time.